Michelle is one that usually gets restricted. and get it back. Maybe you just want them to see the feedback that you sent to them, but you don't want necessarily their own response or whether it's right or wrong, because we're afraid of those pesky screenshots. So all of that stuff, important stuff, happens there on the settings tab. You can do that when you're done building your quiz. I forgot to show that. Questions? Okay. So we're going to spend the rest of the morning before we go to lunch talking about outcomes in grading and how this is going to work for you guys here at DCE. And I did mention we were looking at the agenda that you guys have and are going to get some special customizations that are just for you that the Canvas ProServe department will build for you in the next couple of weeks. I'm going to show you some screenshots of what that's going to look like. And at any time during this part of the presentation, you know, let us know what questions you have, because all that's just going to inform how this is designed and rolled out and then how you communicate it to other teachers and parents and students. So the first thing I wanted to talk about is that we're in the process of getting the content standards into Canvas. And I have a screenshot of what it looks like, just to let you know that the folks who are doing the work, Diane, Felicity, anyone who's helping either one of them, it's not super pretty. So it looks kind of like this. This is a spreadsheet of everything they have to fill out in order to get them into Canvas. So it is a little bit of a process. Diane, English are in for
at least one class.
At least one class.
At each level.
So we're going to use those today. But it is a process. And then Felicity, you have some grade level categories.
First through fifth for Ellen.
Okay, they're in there too. All right. So might not be perfect if you look at it today. No need to panic. It's a process. We're getting them in there. And then this is just some terminology, some Canvas terminology. So standards, what you guys call standards, when they get loaded in, Canvas calls them outcomes. The way outcomes get assessed is on rubrics, or we can attach them like you talked about this morning to a quiz.next quiz or to a regular quiz. Those can be attached there. Now, anything that is assessed that's an outcome is going to inform the Learning Mastery gradebook. And Learning Mastery is the important side for you guys. So this is just a reminder of how it works. So the outcomes, your standards are coming in. Canvas will call them outcomes. Outcomes will get put onto a rubric. You will be able to use that rubric to assess students, and that will inform Learning Mastery. Questions about this?
I'm a little confused.
Go ahead.
So we turned in, let's say, four or five standards for a course that were broken down into a couple of outcomes for each standard. Now you're telling me that the standards are the outcomes. We saw them as two levels, standard and anywhere from one to six outcomes. Now you're saying the standards are the outcomes.
No.
What, you want to explain
the
that?
The outcomes are what get graded. What you will be using as your assessment tool, not the big reporting standard.
Okay. So those teachers that actually had like six outcomes for each of four standards now have 24 outcomes.
But they're not going to have that for every assignment.
No, I understand that.
Correct.
Okay.
To provide more information about what learning is going on, the idea.
Okay.
So Canvas calls your standards outcomes. They'll be loaded in for you, and then you'll be able to use them in your course to give feedback to students on the assessments that you have. All right. courses. We're going to start from there. And we're going to do this process of bringing one or two outcomes into the course. So we may have done this before. You might remember it as we're doing the process together. But I am going to show you what this looks like. I'm actually going to become somebody. Amber is. If you already see an outcome in there, and you might, some of you might see that in there, that's okay. We might have practiced with that before when I was here. You may have either set one up or imported one before. As long as you see a state, you might see an outcome in there, and now you might be able to find. Okay. I think the man fixed it. You might just want to refresh, or you might want to go back to your dashboard and then go back in. I'm going to check with Amber and see what kind of access she has here. We may have.
How do we know?
Well, I can tell as I'm here in Amber's class, I'm into outcomes, and she can't find any. So we're looking for that find button.
I did.
Once you have find, you're good. Yeah, if you can see find, you're in good shape. I'm just trying to figure out what's going on there.
Is there anything in the middle?
fine. We're
like
looking for that fine button.
It's a pretty brutal.
And we're solving a problem right now that no one else will encounter. So we're going to fix it today. And you shouldn't ever see this again. So you can go ahead and click on Find, and you'll see Account Standards. That'll be the first folder you see. We're going to click on Account Standards. And then I'm going to dig in a little bit deeper, and I'm going to go into the DC Everest Area School District. That's what Amber has access to, right? So my elementary folks, this is what you will see. And you guys can select anything you'd like to import. Do you have a suggestion, Felicity?
Or click on elementary.
Okay.
And then there.
All right. So I would click on elementary and then whatever your grade level is. And then you can pick a standard or you can pick the whole grade and then you're going to click import. So for elementary folks, find the standards you would like to be able to use. Now we're going to do the same process so we can see it at the secondary level. And again, all that we have loaded in at the secondary level for folks so far is English. So I'm just going to show what that's going to look like up here for someone at the secondary level. So I will become someone. And Diane, I just want to make sure this is correct. We'll see a junior, what did it say? This one's a senior high.
High middle school.
Yep. So we'll select whichever folder that is. And you'll see English. And I know you're not all English teachers. So just for the purposes of trying this out today, you can just go in there and you can select. If you click here on the top level standard and click import, it's going to bring in both of these at the same time. If you just want to practice importing one standard at a time, if you click all the way down on the individual outcome, we can tell that's the outcome because it has that little bullseye there. We're going to click on that, and then you'll just click import. So we're just going to bring a couple standards in, or a folder of standards, into your course. When you do that, it'll say import successful at the top. So that is step one. Just got to get the outcomes in there. So please do that. We're going to use them next. If you're having a problem or an issue, let me know.
Yeah.
Okay. it'll be there. First step that we're taking is we're saying in this current course success students, we always listen to later. But we do want to go through this process today of importing a standard into the course so we can use it. Because I'm going to show you, we're going to walk through the steps today so you can see exactly how this will look for a teacher and a student. Okay? So once you've imported an outcome, right? So I'm going to pick this one too, and I'm going to click import. It's going to ask you, do you really want to do that? And you're going to say yes. Now once you do, what you're going to see on the outcomes tab is, if we click on this back button, what we can see now is what outcomes are available to use in this course. And to use, we need to put on a rubric, and then to assess students, and then to show up in the Learning Mastery Gradebook. So once you click, either click on that outcomes tab again, or if you click on back, you're going to see right now in this course which outcomes you have available to you. Does anyone have any questions about this so far? And it's okay if you feel really uncomfortable right now. That is normal. Okay? It's okay. This will feel more comfortable to you, I promise. But right now, it's a little bit new, feels a little bit uncomfortable. That's normal. But in this course right now, I've got two outcomes available to me. Does everyone understand that so far? I want to show you before we go any further what I'm talking about available to you. What do you mean, Erin, it's available to you? Well, if I click on grades, it's my traditional side of the grade book. But now I'm going to go ahead and click on Learning Mastery. Those two outcomes now are showing up in here, okay? Because it has said, all right, Erin wants to use these outcomes to assess her students on. So it's creating that space in my Learning Mastery Gradebook for me. I didn't have to do that. Just when I imported it in, that's what I had to do. And now it's going to start setting up that Learning Mastery Gradebook. Bless you. Does that make sense to everybody? Okay, seeing some head shaking, yes. I'm seeing some, but that's okay. It's okay. All right. We've imported outcomes into the course. Outcomes get assessed on rubrics. We also talked about how they get assessed on questions if we're using quizzes next. Now, you guys are lucky here in DC Everest because the way your outcomes are created essentially has created the rubric for you. So there's a step in here that's been taken out by your great admins here. You don't have to worry about that part. It's awesome. And you're going to see what I mean in just a second. So if you want to follow these steps along with me, you certainly can. I'm also going to give you time afterward to try it on your own. But I want to show you how this process is going to work when teachers are creating something in Canvas that they want to assess for their students. So I'm in here, I'm acting as Paul. Paul, you don't mind if I create something here, do you? Okay. So I'm going to add an assignment. And I'm going to call this outcome assignment. And I'm going to spell assignment correctly with the help of my browser. All right. So if I was creating something that I wanted my students to hand in that I wanted to use to assess their learning mastery, I would put all the directions in here, and I would tell them what I wanted them to do. Now, down below, I am going to do things like set a point value, do all my fun things here, and then the submission type I'm going to have for this assignment, I'm going to select text entry. display grade, secondary, display grade as letter grade, and then it's going to show you grading scheme. Your grading scheme is set up in here. Diane has set that in there. You only have to set this up one time in the course. So I'm going to select the standard aligned grading scheme and say use this. It's just going to make it a little bit easier for students. Notice that this is your grading scheme in there. You don't see the grading scheme. Don't panic if you don't see the grading scheme right now. They're saying they're not seeing it.
Right off that rubric,
and then you just see those descriptors. Now, this one up here, the one at the top, we don't have to use this. The one that doesn't have this outcome indicator. This is just if maybe there are some other things we wanted to give students feedback on in addition to the things on the outcomes. So maybe, what could this be? This could be things like use proper formatting or follow directions or hand it in on time. Anything else you might want to give them feedback on to make it easier for you? You can certainly add that in at the top. The ones without that bullseye are not going to talk to Learning Mastery Gradebook. All right? That's just for you to give other comments. If you don't want to use it, we're going to hit that trash can right there. And I'm going to go ahead and click remove points from the rubric. And here's how I want it to look. If for some reason this was not something you wanted to get calculated into the Learning Mastery Gradebook, you still wanted them to give, you wanted to give them the same feedback, but you didn't want it to calculate, notice that you do have a little button right there that says don't post these to Learning Mastery Gradebook. I don't know how often you would use it, but you do have that ability right there. Questions? Thoughts? Go ahead.
If we have assignments where we already created rubrics, how do we edit them at that point?
Right now you have assignments, or that already have rubrics. So you can go into those assignments and either get rid of the rubric that's attached, you'll see a trash can, or you can click on the pencil and that'll allow you to edit it. And that'll allow you to do things like put the outcome.
Thank you. I have become the person who handles all those headphones that move around that the students have. Do you want them sent up to the junior high, the seventh graders' headphones? Do you want to ask somebody?
I'll call Teresa to see what she's been doing. I assume they're the ones for assessment.
Yes.
Yeah.
Should I?
Yeah.
Would you rather I just talk
sure,
to her?
Sure. If you want to, just ask her if she's got, because I know she's got places I think that were storing like keyboards and different types of things as well to help with that process.
Well, every kid has their own set of headphones that they got last year.
Great.
They should be in a Ziploc bag with their name on it.
Oh, great.
We don't label the headphones.
Okay.
We just label the bag.
Sure.
So then we can sanitize them and
great.
Use them for somebody else. But
yeah.
I just want to ask her.
Yeah.
How do you want us to collect those? When we collect them,
sure.
Where should we send them?
Sure.
So
yeah,
I'll just
great.
Deal
okay.
directly with her
okay.
and send them
yeah.
to
thank
her
you.
Attention.
Appreciate it. Yeah.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
How are you?
Get out.
Regulation.
Yeah, I was gonna go Sunday.
Well, I don't know.
that's what it is. It doesn't matter. And it doesn't even matter because there's nothing wrong with it. But I was like, it was late to get an expert.
I'm just walking in front of the big camera.
Is the problem is we have to be able to see how we're going to get something we can understand.
There yet. imported into the course, right? That was important, first thing we have to do.
Remembering to say your assignment, because that's where the conversion.
Yep, have to save the assignment so that you can see the button to add the rubric. Other questions? The reason why we're doing this, why I had you go into this as a student, and you can, if you go back to your assignment, you'll see that up here on the related items, there is the SpeedGrader link. That's going to take you into the SpeedGrader. And just like Paul's already done the card part for me, the greeting. Thank you, Paul, for doing that. So what you're going to see then, again, you're still going to be able to use your SpeedGrader, which I know is a concern this morning on the Padlet. Like, how are we going to be able to use that SpeedGrader with the way that we do things here? So we can see the student's submission. Here is that rubric that we attached. We're going to be able to go ahead and select a criterion, whatever rating we want to give it. You also, in addition to whatever you're selecting here, notice you can leave specific comments. So if you want to give comments about that overall rating that you're putting in there, that is going to be that little talk bubble over there on the right-hand side. So you would go ahead and select those.
So Erin, the thing also is, we've also requested Canvas to keep working on, like, if you have two outcomes to
differentiate,
well, to calculate it up, because unless you put a grade in there, nothing's going to show in the grade book where it says grade.
On the traditional
set.
If a student looked at their grade in Canvas, they would see this. so they can see this for every course currently. Now, what the district has done is, what they will have done, is that second column that you see there, the one with the points, those are going to be removed completely. The students will no longer see that there. And the points that are in the first column will display instead as the District Learning Mastery grading scheme. So this page right now, if you look at it right now as a student, you're going to see it look like this. The customizations are not done. They will be done for you this summer. Those are the things that are going to happen. So when that is done, students and parents, if they look at grades on the web browser, this is what they're going to see. So they will see that that second column is no longer there. That used to have all those individual point values in there. The points will be replaced in the first column, as you can see that, with the District Learning Mastery scheme. And then that total grade that used to be a percentage will now show your grading scheme. Okay? So this is what Canvas is building specifically for you guys. If you look right now, it is not there. This is what will be there, and students and parents will see it this way. Thoughts? Questions? Anything you want to add, Diane?
The infinite canvas is hot, right? The infinite canvas is hot. This side of the grade book. Is that correct? Or should be?
Infinite Campus will talk to the
the no points that are hiding in the book.
The points that are being hidden in will talk to Infinite Campus. Yes.
Okay, so at quarter and at semester when they ask us, hey, you need to post your grades.
Yes.
Quarter is really easy because it's gonna sync. And you can click it there and say, hey, here's a snapshot. But semester, that's when our educators would have to know, okay, let's open up Learning Mastery, let's look at where we're at as the snapshot, and just make sure there's not any huge discrepancies.
Right.
That are comfortable that this is
yes. And there will be a button, it doesn't exist there right now in your gradebook, but it will, that says sync to SIS, and that means push this grade over to Infinite Campus.
We will not have to go in and manually enter a library for a
not. There will be a sync button.
There's a sync button.
There is. It just doesn't work right now.
We're not doing every assignment in the Infinite Campus.
You see a little tick box that says sync to SIS. If you actually want the grades though to go in, you'll see the button in your gradebook. It's not there yet. It's not active. It will be there. Fall. Did I miss anything with this, Diane?
Yeah. You guys have to understand that there is no perfect system out there. Is this where we want it to be right now? No. But this is a milestone compared to what it could have been, having parents see points and percentages. So we have to celebrate the small steps. And again, just try to, how we utilize the tool and how we talk to kids about it is going to be the most important part. And if this grade that shows up for a particular assignment, you always have that ability to go in and change that. That's still your prerogative. So I don't know what else to say about that, but we're trying. It takes time.
And truthfully, I've seen a ton of other systems. None of them really do what you guys want it to do.
No,
so, and that's not a, you know, that's not a dig on anyone. It's just what you want it to do, none of them do. The fact that your district is paying for the extra customization because it's that important, I think we should definitely recognize that. And I think that this will get you closer to where you want it to be. All right, so here's the thing. What are teachers going to see? Because teachers are still going to see both sides. They can see the point values, and they can also see the learning mastery side. So Diane, correct me if I'm wrong about this, if I miss anything. Points and percentages won't be there.
Correct.
Yep. And so we're just going to go with that learning map.
Right. The only thing you will still see, which they are not able to take out for us, is at the very top, you notice the two far right columns. It says this assignment is out of, I don't know, I can't see it from here, 4 or 8 or whatever it is. You'll still see that. We can't get rid of that for you. But know that you already know what that is based on how you're entering it, based on the 4-point scale. So there is a difference. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to marry the learning mastery gradebook with the traditional gradebook, which is why we want to see letter grades here. So at that very top, if you don't enter the 3.5, 2.5, you won't see any scores in this part of your gradebook. So what we're trying to do is try to marry those two so that you see the correlation between the learning mastery and this one. So this is a simplified version. The learning mastery is your feedback tool. Does that make sense? So it's all supposed to. So I'm glad we caught that today, because we thought we had that other scale totally out of the system, so that no matter what you're doing, an A always means the same, no matter what side it goes on.
Okay, thank you. Appreciate it.
one in the
Yeah.